Service says it is tracing 56 contacts identified following the Lassa fever outbreak that has recorded 2 confirmed cases and 1 death. According to the service, it has deployed a team to track the disease from man-to-man transmission to health facilities. Lassa fever is transmitted to humans through contact from or contact with food or household items contaminated with rat and mouse excreta. Dr. Franklin Isiedu Bekwe, who is the director of the public health at the Ghana Health Service, stated that the health management organization is in course with its contact tracing. The Ghana Health Service, GHS, has confirmed 2 cases of Lassa fever in Accra after test by the Noguchi Memorial Institute for Medical Research. The GHS disclosed that the first case was a 40-year-old trader who was unwell for a period of 2 weeks and finally died at the Kulebu Teaching Hospital here in Accra. The second case is a contact of a fatal case and is currently on admission but is very stable. So far, 56 contacts have been identified and are being followed up by the Ghana Health Service. Lassa fever is endemic in Benin, Ghana, Guinea, Liberia, Mali, Sierra Leone, as well as Nigeria. As a result of that, the Ghana Health Service, in a statement signed by the Director General Patrick Kuma Abuaje, noted that the public health emergency committees at all levels have been activated with detailed investigations, including an environmental assessment ongoing. This added that essential medications and logistics, including personal protecting equipment, are being mobilized while contact tracing and management are ongoing. So let's stay a little while on this particular story, because we've been joined on the line by the Director of Public Health at the Ghana Health Service, in the person of Dr. Isiedu Bekwe Franklin. Hello, Doc. Can you hear me? We know of fever, but we are not aware of Lassa. What is Lassa fever?
Is it not Lassa?
Fever. We have heard of fever, the disease fever, but we are not familiar with the word Lassa fever. What is Lassa fever about the disease?
Okay, so Lassa fever is an actually disease caused by the virus called Lassa canus. So it's actually what you call a zoonotic condition, meaning that if human beings get a disease from an animal, and here the animal that will transmit the disease is a rat or a rodent. So what happens is that the virus is in the rodent, and the rodent doesn't get it out. And then it passes the virus through its feces or through its urine onto food, and then that food will be eaten by a man, and man will get infected. So typically what happens is that assuming you have a house, you have a kitchen, you leave less of food and you go to sleep. The guys grab this rats come over, come to feed on your food, pass urine or droplets into your food, and then goes back. You get up in the morning and you go and eat that same food. So, but so you get infected, and then the disease that will come out is called a Lassa fever. So Lassa fever is basically to present as a fever, and then you have also general body weakness and the general malaise. So you can see at the early stages, it's not very different from maybe what you think is malaria. And every time you have other symptoms, you have chest pain, cough, cough, sore throat, maybe you have difficulty breathing, and then they may even get into coma at the advanced stage. And the last stage is whereby you tend to have bleeding from several openings in your body. So you have bleeding to your mouth, so you're not bleeding from your vagina, and then you may die. So that is the cause of the asthma. The bleeding blood is normally between 2 to 21 days. And I'll say that there's a definitive medicine to manage asthma. It's an antiviral agent.
Oh, okay.
And there's no vaccine for it. So the main thing is to prevent the disease. Those are the basic things that I can tell you about asthma.
Doc, how long has this disease existed? Is this something new to the country? Has this disease existed? Is this something new to the country?
The first time we had in Ghana was 2011.
2011.
So 2011, we had 2 cases of asthma in Asante region. After that, we haven't really had such cases. But let me say that there are several countries around Ghana that is endemic. We have Nigeria, Benin, Sierra Leone, Gabia, all have this. But I think that the important thing to state is that the reservoir is quite common in the country. So it's possible we have people who are getting the infection and they are not getting the disease. So about 80% of people who get the infection do not actually show any disease. So that is the situation of NASA. So it's not very new, though it's not very common.
And what are some of the measures we are putting in place to ensure that we properly fight this particular disease?
Yeah, so for now, what happens is that we have the report, we mobilize all our Asian scientists to the meeting so that they also went on to activate all their regional public health medicine committees. So then we have also mobilized a number of medicines and other places, the management of cases being the outbreak of that case and management. And let me say that, the first day we did a release, we had 56 chronicles. Now, after yesterday, that's it's possible to go up. What we are doing, we are trying to identify all possible exposures to the virus. And then, by when you're able to do that, I'm sure we're able to contain the disease. So that's what we are trying to do. We're also trying to make sure we improve on communication for the general public to understand what is that's a feedback and how you can prevent it.
Thanks for your time, Doc.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. Yeah, thank you. We've been speaking to the Director of Public Health at the Ghana Health Service in the person of Dr. Isiedu Bekwin Franklin. We were delving more into issues related to the lesser fee.